The 40mm grenades are divided into three types: low velocity, medium velocity, and high velocity. Low and medium velocity grenades are used in portable grenade launchers, high velocity grenades are used in high velocity grenade machine guns. Each grenade has the same caliber, but differs in length. Low velocity grenades have range of about 400 meters. Medium velocity grenades have a range of 700 to 800 meters. Medium velocity grenades travel farther, so the pressure on the barrel when fired is greater. Conventional portable grenade launchers can withstand the pressure of medium velocity grenades. Because high velocity grenades travel more than 2 kilometers, the pressure on the barrel when firing is greater. So, when firing high velocity grenade, a high velocity grenade machine gun is used. This is a MK19 high velocity grenade machine gun. It has a barrel at the front and a cover on top. There is a front side on the cover, and there is a rear side on the back. There are loading handles on both sides, which are used for charging by pulling backwards. There is a trigger and trigger handle on the back. The percussion handle is connected to the bolt ball and spring. There is a bundle of sabot slides on the top cover, which pulls out grenades one by one. Inside of it are primary driving lever, secondary driving lever, and vertical cam. There is a bunch of single shots at the bottom. First, open the top cover and slide the grenade into the ammunition guide. The ammunition guide prevents grenades from twisting when fired at high speed. Pull out the grenade and place it next to the first detent on the sabot slide. The detent serves to hold the grenade from being pushed. Place the grenade and close the top cover. Next, pull loading handle backwards. When the loading handle moves backward, the primary driving lever moves to the left. The secondary drive lever moves to the right. The projectile detent connected to the secondary drive lever also moves to the right, and the projectile detent moves the grenade. This will align the rightmost grenade with the bolt extractor. Then, when you press the trigger, the bolt bundle is pushed forward. The bolt extractor fits into the rim of the cartridge case. When the extractor is inserted into the grenade, pressure can be applied to the grenade, which can damage the grenade. The ammo buffer in front of the grenade absorbs this shock. Pulling the loader handle again will push the bolt back and release the grenade from the belt. The curved edge of the vertical cam pushes the grenade down the extractor. The grenade goes into the bolt. The lowered grenade gets caught in the latch underneath the bolt. When the bolt is fully retracted, the grenade is aligned with the chamber and is ready to be fired. At this point, the extractor is aligned with the second grenade and ready to extract it. When you press the trigger, the receiver sear and the single shot stack goes down. The force of the compressed spring moves the bolt forward. The caulking lever is caught in the slot and is pushed back. As the bolt sear collides with the metal plate in front, the firing pin sear is released and moves forward by the force of the spring. The firing pin ignites the grenade detonator and the grenade is fired. The force of the explosive gas also pushes the bolt back. As it is pushed back, a newly extracted grenade enters the bolt and pushes the casing down. When the bolt is pushed back, the sear gets engaged and is ready to fire again. When the adjustment lever is set to S, the safety lever locks the receiver sear. Receiver sear does not go down, even when the trigger is pressed, so it does not fire. When placed on F, the receiver sear will descend and fire. If you hold down the trigger, the sears will not engage with each other and fire continuously. The rear side is displayed from 300 meters to 1,500 meters in 100 meter increments. Align the rear sight with the front sight to fire the grenade. The maximum range of the grenade is 2200 meters, but effective range is 1500 meters. A 40mm grenade has similar power to a standard grenade, but since it is flown from a launcher, it has a very long range. The grenade is fired at a speed of 241 milliseconds and travels about 2 kilometers. The recoil is great as the thrust of the high-velocity grenade is strong. Because of the large recoil, tripod is used to fire grenades. The grenade can fire 300 fragments, killing people within 10 meters. The MK19 fires grenades at a rate of 350 shots per minute. If a lot of these grenades are delivered in a short time, the destructive power will be very high. While automatic grenade launcher is usually used on the ground, it can also be used on moving vehicles. Development of the MK19 have begun in 1963, and the first version was a hand-crank grenade launcher called the MK18. An early model of the MK19 was developed in 1966, but it was unreliable and unsafe for use as a weapon. A redesigned model of the MK19 came out in 1976 and is still in use today. Thank you for watching till the end.